He's got it! The hat trick
for Butch Davis!
Butch Davis!
Tonight, and the Hats are flying to Denver. Pavel Buchnevich with an incredible shift on the penalty kill there for the St. Louis Blues. Braden Shen, he's up too. All the boys are celebrating. You don't get one, you get two hat tricks tonight for the price of one. Another shorthanded goal for the Blues, and the third goal of the night for Pavel Buchnevich. He's gassed here. He's digging in deep just to get ahead of the players. And then what tremendous patience. Goes forehand here, all the way back to backhand, in control of his body, and puts the puck behind the goal line. And Bucci, a little fist pump there. He's happy.
Oh, yeah.
And this marks the third time in Blues history they have had two different players, get a hat trick in the same game. The last time before tonight, Doug Gilmore and Mark Hunter on February 23rd, 86 in Hartford.
Wow.
The last time until tonight.
That's a long time.
That's a long time.
And two short-handed goals for Buchnevich as he gets his third career hat trick.
Yeah, they were mentioned earlier, the last time the Blues put up a 6 point or more on the Avalanche was 96, but that's played in the McNichols Arena. John Kelly should remember that. He used to do play-by-play for the Blues when Kenny Wilson, then when the Avalanche came for Quebec, so they had John Kelly do the play-by-play for the Avalanche. Kenny Wilson did full-time for the Blues.
Really, he's been really, really good for the Blues, but, you know, Roberts has scored goals in five straight games leading up to this. Tonight, he takes care of business by passing the puck around, letting his teammates score some of the goals.
So the four assists, one shy of a career high of five assists for Robert Thomas, which he did in Buffalo back in 22.
But I always remember that John Kelly started his play-by-player with the Blues.
Back, intended for Wood, and now it's Parayko ahead, and he gets it out. So the Blues are 3-for-3 on the kill with two shorthanded goals. And on the power play tonight, they're 2-for-4.
Yeah, special teams. They can make or break you as a hockey club. And the Blues been able to take advantage of that as we got a little skirmish here down in front of Jordan Binnington as the Avalanche players continue to...
And the Blues don't like players don't like that.
Gun, but again, five white jerseys down there protecting the paint.
And the Blues now with four shorthanded goals this year. And that ties the NHL lead. Well, the Blues are proud to host Nurses Night, a special tribute dedicated to the nurses in our community.
Number 30th.
Number 30th, presented by Shift Med. Purchase a theme night ticket and receive an exclusive Blues belt bag. Perfect for nurses on the go to get your seats.
That's a nice belt bag right there.
/theme.
Man, a blueprint. Listen to Affen. They're not happy.
And the Blues up 7-1. That last goal, Buchnevich from Thomas. And now Jordan Kyrou. On to center ice. He'll dump it in. All the way around, and Scandella cannot get there in time.
And that's I can hear it now as soon as I drop this video and upload it. Sweet Sugar's gonna come on this video. She said, "Yeah, the ads play like crap. They didn't even show up."
Offensive zone face-off. It's also an opportunity for some guys to get some playing time.
She said, "That's okay. My boys will bounce back."
Albeit the Kasperi Kapanen injury, I guess, or him not being on the bench does allow him to do that. But he is trying to get a little more playing time for a lot of guys here.
So the Blues a season high 7 goals tonight. About to win their second in a row. And fourth in 5 games. And now they come home for one Tuesday against Tampa Bay. And by the way, lost tonight and did not have Nikita Kucherov. He was ill.
Both guys blanked by the Hurricane, 4-0.
We know from watching him for years just how much he can drive the offense. So we got a team without him. It's certainly more of an uphill battle.
There's Scandella pass to center. That's out of the reach of Falk. Tatar back in for the Avalanche. For Byram. Shoots it. Tip wide. Maybe by Olsson. And then Byram again. Slides it across for Girard.
Hey, Binnington bobblehead giveaway.
Girard.
December 14th.
The corner working on Falk. And the puck fanned on by Tatar, and it comes back to center ice.
1 minute remaining in the period.
With a minute to go in the third. Broken up by Oscar Sundquist. Now to Tarchenko. Two on one to the net. And a save. And they jam it in.
Whoa!
And the Blues have scored again. Maybe Sundquist, I'm not sure. Now the goaltender, Prozvatov, is going to argue that he had it covered and it was jammed in.
Yeah, I don't think he's, I don't think the goalie's correct on this one. He might be angry, but that puck
vantage
point looked like it was still available.
He's going to lose that argument because he did not have it covered. The puck was still loose.
Play until you hear the whistle.
And there was no whistle blown.
As Oscar Sundquist passes it to Torpchenko, he stops here. He keeps banging away at the puck. And then
that puck was still loose, yeah, and whacked away.
Clearly loose, and I don't know if Torpchenko touches it last. We'll get a good look at it here. It is.
Oh.
It's Alexei Torpchenko sticking with it, but why did he get that goal? Because he stopped right at the blue paint. He didn't do the flyby. He stopped right there, and he kept battling until the whistle, and he gets rewarded for it.
He gets a second goal of the year. It comes at 19-11. And that makes it 8-1. Avalanche will chip it back in. Now Binnington, quick handoff up the wall. Johnson at the line, shoots and he scores. Jack Johnson makes it 8-2. His first of the year.
Yeah, not sure if George Binnington was screened on this. Johnson does get good wood on that. Just seems to beat Jordan Binnington short side. So the Avs getting their second goal of the game late in the third period, only 27.3 seconds remaining.
So that makes it 8-2. A goal at 19:32 for Jack Johnson. That's tipped by Drouin all the way down. And a wandering Binnington around for Blake. That's chopped back of the goal. Avalanche play it back now for Johnson. Drouin shot blocked. Blues clear it. And that'll do it. They win 8-2 tonight in Denver. And for Craig Berube, his 200th win.
There you go.
Blues head coach.
200 as a Blue head coach.
Fantastic coach. Gets rewarded with his 200th win. And a lot of what he's been saying over the last week or so came to fruition tonight. Power play to stick with it, getting to the inside, getting to the blue paint. Guys get rewarded for that. We take a look here for our Hyundai players of the game, plural. And that's because two guys
Hyundai players, that's right. Couple hat tricks.
Great look at these goals as Braden Shen rips that one. Top cheese, please, for Braden Shen.
Since February 23rd, 1986 at Hartford.
Drive into the net, a fantastic move at the end, and putting that in on the backboard.
Yeah, that was his second shorthanded goal tonight. His third career hat trick. As the Blues blow out the Avalanche in Denver, 8-2 the final.